Hello, this is session number 9 and today we are going to discuss different CMMI models and how to use these different CMMI models. Now the complexity of products, if you look at all the products, they demand an integrated view of how organizations do the business. So CMMI can reduce the cost of process improvement across enterprises that depend on multiple functions or groups to achieve the objectives. Now to achieve this integrated view, the CMMI framework includes common terminology, common model components, common appraisal methods, and common training materials. So in this session, we will discuss how the organizations can use the CMMI product suite not only to improve the quality, reduce the cost, optimize the schedules, but also to gauge how well their process improvement program is working or is going on. Now we will discuss about the role of different process standards and process definitions. Now there is a long tradition of standards like DoD standard 21670 that were intended to tell the software developers what they must do to achieve an acceptable level of professional practice. In the last few years, the binary form of pass-fail kind of evaluation has lost the favor and a more graded approach has been developed for assessing the maturity or capability of the developers' processes. So it is not just pass or fail, it is not just developed or not developed, it is not just like correct and wrong. But now we will give the grades that this is correct but it is at grade 1, this is correct but it is at grade 2, level 3, level 4. So that graded approach has come into the picture instead of the binary evaluation method. Now the ISO IEC, which is 15504 standard, this is a process assessment standard, which is commonly called as SPICE. SPICE stands for Software Process Improvement and Capability Determination, with E in the determination, SPICE. Now this describes the approach for the graded assessment. Few other process reference models are also there, like ISO IEC 12207, which is the IEEE standard, which is for software lifecycle process, and ISO IEC 15288, which is also IEEE standard, but this is for system lifecycle processes. So the important question is whether any other standards are needed for process definition, or we can simply implement the process or processes which are meeting the CMMI criteria. Now there are four reasons why one should consider using process standards for defining an organizational process. Now these four reasons are scope, suitability, communication, and robustness. So the first is scope. When I say scope, although CMMI is broad, it is not broad enough for all the possible uses. So for example, consider quality management. Although CMMI includes provisions addressing the quality of software products and systems, it does not address the organizational level of quality management system, which is actually specified by ISO 9001. So which is a quality management system. So because ISO 9001 conformance is regarded as highly important in many countries, multinational suppliers will find it appropriate to consider that standard in defining their processes. Second reason is suitability. Not every organization needs the same set of processes. Every organization has some unique characteristics and that cause it to differ it from all the other organizations or specifically from the competitors. Now that competitive advantage should be addressed in the organizational processes so that the advantage is relevantly applied to every project of the organization by maintaining its competitive advantage or edge. Now, defining a set of organizational processes, for example, software and system engineering, they should consider a number of factors, kind of size of the organization, the nature of the products or the kind of services which are provided by the organization, the competitive structure of the marketplace, the nature of the competition, then the regulatory structure and the regulatory requirements, custom traditions, other regulations as per the industry sector. The organizational attitudes towards the quality, what is the meaning of quality in that certain domain, then the amount of investment capital available for process definition, then the uniformity or the diversity of anticipated project requirements, and the form in which the documentation is to be captured, saved, and possibly delivered. So all these things are very important. All these considerations and many more affect the definition of the organizational processes, leading to the conclusion that the selection and implementation of cost-effective processes requires a different solution for every organization. Now the third reason is communication. Another important reason for considering process standard is communication. Now terminology in software engineering are very vague and flexible, which can lead to misunderstanding. For example, when you get paid for implementing the software, does not mean that you should test it also. You may have not included that in the price. So even the consideration of proposal is difficult without a baseline of terminology for comparing the processes. Suppose a buyer asks the supplier what sort of design review practices are performed by a supplier. One possible answer is to provide dozens of pages of details that what sort of standard practices you are following. Another possible answer is the supplier can just say we use IEEE standard 1028. Now that one statement is sufficient because this IEEE standard 1028 is a software review standard. And if you are following this standard, that means you are taking care of all the things which are mentioned by this IEEE 1028 standard. Now this second answer has an advantage as it is very precise in terms of what it is included and what and it is also acceptable as a responsible practice also. So the international standards for lifecycle processes like ISO IEC 12207 or the 15288, they provide a comprehensive set of processes that span the life cycles of software products and systems. If a supplier states that its software development process conforms to that of 12207, a buyer knows the answer to a large number of questions, what doubts a supplier can have. So to pick only one example, the buyer would know that the software requirements, the architectural design, the detailed design and the code will be evaluated for feasibility of operations and maintenance because that is part of the standard 12207. And the last reason is robustness. So reliance on a single source may lead to defining processes that are oriented towards a particular concept of usage. So it is impossible to anticipate all possible situations. Any situation which happens in any domain. So it is up to the process designer to consult multiple sources to find processes that are suitable to that particular organization in that domain. So these are the four reasons which are very important, like as we have discussed, scope, suitability, communication, and robustness. So these four reasons one should consider using process standards, which process standards should be used for defining and organizing processes. Now, in terms of adopting the CMMI, research has shown that the most powerful initial step to process improvement is to build organizational support through strong senior management sponsorship. So there has to be a strong backing from the senior management, or the task has to be senior management driven. To gain the sponsorship of senior management, it is often beneficial to expose them to the performance results experienced by the others who have used the CMMI to improve their processes. So if other companies, other departments, competitors have used CMMI and if they have improved their processes, that results, those results and their comparisons, you can give it to the senior management. The senior manager, once committed as the process improvement sponsor, must be actively involved in the CMMI-based process improvement effort in this step-by-step process. So activities performed by the senior management sponsor include a lot of things like influence the organization to adopt the CMMI, because senior management can always influence a whole organization. They can influence the organization to choose the best practices and the best people to manage the process improvement efforts. Monitor the process improvement efforts personally and be a visible advocate and spokesperson for the process improvement effort. So that is what is expected. It is also expected to ensure senior management to ensure that adequate resources are available to enable the process improvement effort to be successful. So available from the available resources, whatever number of resources are required for process improvement, those adequate resources should be available at all the time. Given sufficient senior management sponsorship, the next step is establishing a strong, technically competent process group that represents relevant stakeholders to guide the process improvement efforts. For an organization with a mission to develop software-intensive systems, the process group might include those who represent different disciplines across the organization and other selected members, which are based on the business needs which are driving towards the improvement. For example, a system administrator may focus on information technology support, whereas a marketing representative may focus on integrating customer needs. But if you are taking both the members, they could make powerful contribution to the process group. Once your organization decides to adopt CMMI, planning can begin with an improvement approach such as the Ideal model. Ideal model, IDEAL. Ideal model stands for initiating, diagnosing, then establishing, acting, and learning. So that is the Ideal model. Now you must make three sections, or the, sorry, you must make three selections to apply CMMI to your to the organization for process improvement. The first is select a part of the organization which you want to include, select a model which you want to implement, and select a representation. Now, selecting the project to be involved in your process improvement program is very critical. If you select a group that is too large, it may be too much for the initial improvement effort. So to begin with, you should select a small group. The selection should also consider organizational, product, and work homogeneity. That is, whether the group's members all are expert in the same discipline, and whether they all work on the same product or business line, and so on. Selecting an appropriate model is also essential to a successful process improvement program. The CMMI development model focuses on activities for developing quality product and services, whereas CMMI ACQ, that is acquisition model, focuses on activities for initiating and managing the acquisition of products and services. And CMMI SVC, this model focuses on the activities for providing quality service to the customers and the end users. So we have different models which are available. So when selecting a model, appropriate consideration should be given to the primary focus of the organization and the products or and the projects. Now, the processes which are necessary to satisfy business objectives should also be part of this selection process. The lifecycle processes, for example, conception, design, manufacture, deployment, operations, you can say maintenance, disposal, all these processes on which an organization concentrates should also be considered when selecting the appropriate model. Now, select the representation. That capability or maturity level that fits your concept of process improvement is also very important. Regardless of which method you choose or which representation you choose, you can select nearly any process area or group of processes to guide the improvement. Although dependencies among processes process areas should be considered when making such a selection. As process improvement plans and activities progress, other important selections must be made, like in whether to use an appraisal method, which appraisal method, which assessment method, which project should be selected for the appraisal method, how training for the staff should be secured, and which staff members should be trained, and all these things, all these kind of decisions. CMMI models describes best practices that organizations have found to be productive and useful to achieve the business objectives. Now, regardless of the organization, you must use powerful judgment when interpreting CMMI best practices for your situation, your needs, and the kind of business objectives which your organization can have. So this use of judgment is reinforced when you see words like adequate, appropriate, or as needed. So these kind of wording is all generally used in different CMMI models. interpret these goals and practices in ways that work for your organization. Although process areas depict the characteristics of an organization committed to process improvement, you must interpret the process areas using an in-depth knowledge of CMMI and your organization and the business environment of your organization. As you begin using CMMI model to improve the organization processes, you need to start mapping your real-world processes to CMMI process areas. Now, this mapping enables you to initially judge and later track your organization's level of conformance to the CMMI model, which you are using, and you are trying to identify opportunities for the improvement. Now, to interpret practices, it is important to consider the overall context in which these practices are used and to determine how well the practices satisfy the goals of a process area in that context. Now, the important thing is interpreting CMMI when using Agile approach. So, CMMI practices are designed to provide value across a range of different situations, and thus they are stated in general terms. So, because CMMI does not endorse any particular approach to development, little information that is approach specific is provided. To help those who use Agile method to interpret CMMI practices in their environments, notes have been added to the selected process areas. And these notes are added usually in the introductory notes to the following process area in the CMMI development. So in case of support group, there are two process areas like CM, which is configuration management, and PPQA, which is process and product quality assurance. So the notes related to Agile method are added into the introductory section of these two process areas. In terms of project management areas, there are four process areas: PMC, project monitoring and control; PP, which is project planning; REQM, which is requirement management; and RSKM, which is risk management. In terms of engineering also, we have four process areas: PI, product integration; RD, which is requirements development; TS, which is technical solution; and verification. Now, all the notes which are in the introductory section, they begin with the word "in agile environments." So whenever you will find any statement which has these three words, "in agile environment," these are the notes specifically added to implement CMMI best practices in agile environment. And these are example boxes to help you to easily recognize them and remind you that these notes are examples of how to interpret practices and therefore are neither necessary nor sufficient for implementing the process area. Now, agile environment and agile method approaches are characterized by three things. First is direct involvement of the customer in the product development. Second is use of multiple development iterations to learn about and evolve the product. And third is customer willingness to share the responsibility for decisions and risk. So this is all about agile environment. So this is the end of session number 9, where we have discussed different process standards in which are available, then different ways of adopting CMMI, how we can apply CMMI models, and which are the different CMMI models related to agile methods.